What a great day in Piedmont Park.
It's beautiful, but it's a little chilly.
It is autumn time.
This glorious fall is here. You know, tonight we're talking with Youth Pride a little bit and talking about their new center that's in Decatur. They've opened up a brand new place for all the kids to gather, and it's a great accomplishment for our community.
Youth Pride is a great group.
Yeah, it is.
And what else?
Well, the Anti-Defamation League and Barnes & Noble team up for the Close the Book on Hate campaign, and they read Heather Has Two Mommies to a group of children at story time. It's really cute.
And they're really trying to ban the book bans around the country, aren't
exactly.
they?
Exactly.
And we're going to be talking to David Mixner, who was described as the most powerful gay man in America, and we said we'd be talking to him tonight, and we are. We saw him last week at this time at the Atlanta Executive Network.
It's a wonderful speech he gave.
It really was.
Very moving. Also, I'm speaking with Chris Rice, who's an author of the book A Density of Souls. Of course, his mother is Anne Rice, the award-winning novelist, so it was very exciting to interview him.
He's a cutie.
Yeah, he is.
I saw him on the cover of The Advocate recently.
I saw him, too. He's a cutie.
Yeah. Well, we're going to kick everything up with Savannah's first Pride. It was a wonderful success, and congratulations, Savannah. Stick around for all the highlights. Yes.
Each of us has an important reason for walking in AIDS Walk Atlanta.
Because every 13 minutes, one more American is infected with HIV.
Because I know that the new treatments mean hope, not victory.
Because I want kids to grow up in a world free of AIDS.
And because AIDS is still a crisis, period.
Register today for AIDS Walk Atlanta, a 10-kilometer fundraising walkathon benefiting AIDS Atlanta and other AIDS service and education providers. Call 404-876-WALK.
Why will you walk?
Club One is proud to sponsor OutTV Savannah. Come to Club One, Savannah's number one dance bar.
Because this is Savannah's inaugural Pride Fest.
Despite rains and overcast skies, Savannah Pride Fest 2000, the city's first ever gay pride celebration, brought out thousands of gay men, lesbians, bisexuals, and transgendered people this past weekend. Friday night, OutTV Atlanta helped First City Network, a host of Savannah Pride, celebrate its 15th anniversary at a dinner and awards ceremony at Deja Groove in the heart of the famous coastal city. Saturday's rainy skies gave way to happy sunshine over historic Roundhouse, a converted railway terminal, where up to 5,000 gay and gay-friendly folk focused on the weekend event. State Senator Vincent Fort, who championed the successful passage of anti-hate crime legislation in the 2000 Georgia General Assembly, led off the official opening ceremony.
Gay and lesbians were in the forefront of the cause for hate crimes legislation. But it wasn't just gay and lesbians. It was black people. It was Latino people. It was women's rights groups that came together and passed the hate crimes law. Some people thought it couldn't happen, but it did happen, and that's because Georgia's changing. Now, have we changed it enough? Let me ask you, have we changed it enough? Are we gonna change it some more?
A food court, vendors market, art fair, and beautiful panels of the famed AIDS quilt set the stage for Saturday's festive day-long tribute to Savannah Gay Life.
I long to have near me, to feel that last sweet embrace, to share all the joy and ease all the pain, and no one can take your place. And I don't know how to tell you how much you meant to me. All of the things you taught me, it's so hard to set you free, set you free.
Musical groups throughout the afternoon sparked jubilant response. Pop duo Mark Etheridge and Dean Wong a gay singing twosome from Hawaii, echoed songs from their hit albums Walking into Freedom and Man of My Dream. Other musical ensembles included Liquid Ginger, Girlfriends, and sexy Latin songster Jade Esteban Estrada, who some say looks like, well, you can decide.
I was turned and anger set in, and I was all alone. In this strange land, I had no friends, so I couldn't pick up the phone. I used to have so many friends, this loneliness felt strange. I didn't like the way I felt, I knew life had to change. I want to be happy, no more loneliness, no more fear.
Amid all the glamour, OutTV Atlanta's Jody Hanvey found the famous Lady Chablis, the drag songstress who helped John Cusack in Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil unfurl the murder of Kevin Spacey's young lover.
We're glad that you all came down with the cameras and everything to see what's going on in Savannah. It's our inaugural Pride Fest, so it's our very first one, and I'm so proud to be here. Now, what's going on with me personally is I'm reading two scripts for two movies that's coming up. I am going to be doing several Caribbean cruises as the entertainer. I'm also doing some casinos in Biloxi, Mississippi.
Working or gambling?
Both. Oh, and I forgot one, shopping. Yes, and stuff like that. So, I mean, my life is it's ongoing. And some people say to me sometimes, I have friends that come up to me and they say, well, Chablis, I haven't seen you in the movie. Your 15 minutes of fame is up. But as everyone knows, I'm going to take my time and I'm going to have me a good old 60 minutes of this. I really am. But I got to tell you something else.
Okay.
I will never abandon the South.
Thank you. You will never abandon the South. You heard it here first. We'd like to thank the Lady Chablis. Love you, darling.
Love you too, darling. Yeah. Love you too.
In all Savannah Pride Fest 2000, take pride, take joy, take action, was a tremendous symbol of how Georgia's first historic city has moved from gay tolerance to gay acceptance as it enters the 21st century. And OutTV Atlanta has left its own mark on this first ever event with OutTV Savannah, a sister program, which will air weekly on Tuesdays at 10:30 p.m. on Savannah Cable Channel 7. This is Rob Martin reporting for OutTV Atlanta.